We know force is a push or pull. Consider a body that is subjected to different forces. To determine the net effect of applied forces on a body, we have to add or subtract forces. When we talk about forces, you can intuitively feel that a force has direction. I think this is obvious. If I push the object in this direction, my force is from left to right. Instead of saying left to right or right to left, we can use north, south, or east. Or we can use angle to define the direction of a force. It is also obvious that a force has some value. Value is a number, and we call this quantity as magnitude. Magnitude can be large or small. If I apply a 10-pound force, I can say this force has a magnitude of 10. Finally, it is important for us to know where the force is applied, and we call this point of application. So force is a physical quantity that has direction, magnitude, and point of application. Let's take a look at an example force. This diagram shows a force called F. The direction of the force is defined by an angle from the horizontal line, and the magnitude of this force is 100 newton. Force is not the only quantity that has direction and magnitude. There are other quantities. Velocity is another example that has got direction and magnitude. Similarly, acceleration is also a physical quantity that has direction and magnitude. Engineers call quantities that has got direction and magnitude as vector. And vector is a very, very important concept in engineering design. So let us take a closer look at vectors in the next video.